In this video, you'll see how to install eTutor on a Linux server. So to begin with, you can find the documentation on how to install eTutor or upgrade eTutor through the documentation link on eTutor.ca. Once you've had a read through the documentation, go to the download site, click on Download eTutor, which takes you to the SourceForge website, the primary distribution site for eTutor. It should start downloading momentarily. We save that file to your local system. And since I already have it saved there, I'll just skip this part. So once you've got the eTutor bundle saved to your local system, open up your FTP program. In this case, I'm using WinSCP. And you want to copy the tar gzip file you just downloaded onto the server where you intend to install it. So copy it over. The bundle onto the server where eTutor will be accessible from the internet. Now I need to unzip it. Sometimes your FTP program will allow you to do that, in this case not. So you need to log in through an SSH client in most cases. So in this case I've got a copy of PuTTY available, and I'm in the directory where I've just uploaded the eTutor bundle. And there it is there, eTutor 202. So I want to unpack that. Tar xzvf eTutor. And then that unbundles the entire thing. So now you go to your web browser and you type in the URL to the installation directory. And it brings up, once your eTutor bundle is unzipped on the server, you go to the install directory and it brings up the installer. Click on continue the installation. On the first screen, eTutor checks to make sure that you have all the necessary requirements to run eTutor, including all the libraries, version of MySQL and PHP, for instance. If you happen to be missing a library, in some cases it's okay, you can still continue, such as if you're missing curl, for instance. It's not a requirement to run eTutor itself, but it is a requirement to run eTutor Social. So in a case like that, you would be missing eTutor Social from your eTutor installation, but the LMS itself would work just fine. If you get the red check mark failed, it means that something that is critical to running eTutor is missing, and you'll need to update your system to fix that problem, either changing a PHP setting or installing a library or something like that, upgrading MySQL in some cases to the appropriate version. So once all your requirements are met, click on Install, which takes you to the Terms of Use page. In this case, you need to agree to the terms of the GNU General Public License, the GPL. Click on I Agree, and then you set up your initial database information. So the database user in this case, database a name. In some cases you may need to set up the database ahead of time if your MySQL user doesn't have create database privileges. Click on Next. Sets up the tables for eTutor. Ensure that there are no errors in this list. If there are, then you'll need to correct them. on Next once the database is installed and set up your initial users. So first the admin user. Contact email. A personal account for the first instructor. And then click Next. Now you need to set up the content directory for AATutor. In most cases, at least when you're installing on a Linux system, this will have to be done manually. On Windows systems, it will be created automatically. So to create it, open up your PuTTY, in this case, or your shell, to the server that AATutor is installed on. And if you click CD to the AATutor directory, you'll see there are all the AATutor files. So in the root directory where we are now, we want to create a directory called content. It can be called anything actually, but in most cases you'll want to call it content for consistency purposes. So KDIR content, and then go back to AATutor installer and click Next. It's going to complain that the content directory is not writable, so you need to set the permissions on the directory, and the instructions are right here to make it writable by the web server. So to do that, we do chmod a plus read, write, and execute on the content directory. Like that, and now we should be able to continue. Now we need to make the configuration file writable as well. So the configuration file is in the includes directory. Include config.inc.php. So we'll make that writable. CHMOD space A plus RWX config.inc.php, and that's done. Go and try again. So everything's been saved. Click on to the next step. So on this step, it tells you that everything has been installed, and it's going to send off some basic information about your server. This is all kept private. It's just to help in the creation of AATutor and improve support. So you can send the URL to your installation or not. So in this case, we will just uncheck that so it doesn't send the URL to my installation off to the AATutor database. Click on Next, and that's it. You're done. Before you finish your installation, you'll want to delete the install directory, and you'll want to remove the write permissions from the config.inc file. This is all described right here in the instructions. So now I click on the login button. And there you go. I can log in as admin. So most of the settings that you're going to want to adjust are under System Preferences. And we'll go through all of these, but you can read through them. Here's descriptions of all of the settings in the System Preferences help file, right up here at the top corner. If you're installing modules, click on the Modules tab. You can get a listing of the modules that are currently available for this installation, as well as installing new modules. In this case, it will get a list of the available modules for eTutor down here. Or if you have one you've downloaded, you can upload the zip file and install it manually. If you're installing languages, you can go to System Preferences, click on the Languages tab, and you can get a listing of the available languages for this version of eTutor by clicking on Import. In the lower box, choosing the language that you want to import. So I'll import one here, let's say Arabic. Import that, goes out to the eTutor website, gets the language and installs it. So now I can click on Arabic and I have an Arabic version of eTutor. So that's the basics for installing eTutor. There's a lot more configuration options. See the eTutor handbook in the administrator section of the handbook for details about configuring eTutor to your needs.